we're very excited to announce the release of Oxygen 26, and in this video we will show you some highlights of new features and updates that were implemented in this version. Oxygen's new AI Positron Assistant add-on provides a powerful tool to help writers use AI-generated content. It contributes an AI Positron Assistant side view that contains a variety of AI-powered actions. Some of them have a settings icon to configure options for that particular action. This action instructs the AI to generate a short description for the current topic. You can see the response from the AI server in the chat view on the right, and actions are available under each response depending on the action. For instance, you could preview the response, or copy it to the clipboard, or insert to add the AI-generated short description in the document. Next, we'll intentionally create a grammar problem. And select the paragraph. And then we can use the correct grammar action. This time we'll click preview. And it opens a file comparison where you can clearly see the changes that the AI suggested. And if you agree with the changes, you can apply them. Next, we'll select a paragraph and choose the Improve Readability action. You can use the box at the bottom of the chat view to refine the response by sending a message to the AI platform, and it will generate a new response based on your message. You can click this icon that appears to the right of the response to edit your message or send further instructions. We'll click Replace to insert the generated response. A history dropdown in the top right corner offers a way to quickly select recently used actions. For complex instructions that the AI may not be able to accurately complete without further assistance, you can click the Record button in the top left corner of the assistant view. You can provide a set of instructions for the AI to follow. After clicking the Start Recording button at the bottom of the dialog box, you can then execute a series of actions in the editing area that will serve as a collection of examples to help the AI process the complex instructions. For example, in our case, we're showing the AI how to convert text that looks like menu items into a menu cascade, which requires consecutive UI control elements that are wrapped in a menu cascade element. Then, after clicking the Stop Recording button, you have the ability to save the final result either as a favorite chat prompt or as a custom Positron action. After giving it a name, a description, and configuring the action, you would click Save Instructions, and it creates a JSON file that defines the action, and that action is now available in the Other section in the Assistant view. To test it, we'll select content that contains text structure that we want to convert and click the new custom action. And we'll choose replace. And you can see that it converted it to the complex structure that we recorded. If you save the recorded instruction as a favorite prompt, it'll be available in the drop-down menu at the bottom of the chat view. DITA authors now have the ability to extract a selection of content into a new DITA topic. After selecting the content, in this case a section, you can right-click and you now have access to a new action called Extract Topic from Selection. It triggers the usual DITA topic creation wizard, and the result is a new DITA topic based on the selected content. If change tracking is enabled in author mode, when renaming an XML element, the change is now tracked as an element deletion followed by the newly renamed element insertion. This provides a more accurate representation of the result of the renaming process. A new Merge Documents with Change Tracking Highlights action is available in the Tools menu. It can be used to merge two XML files based on a two-way comparison. All the files involved in the process are merged by saving the visual comparison results as a separate document, with the tracked changes visible where it will be easy to review and accept or reject the changes. Similarly, a merge directories with change tracking highlights action is also available. It can be used to merge two directories, and all pairs of modified XML files involved in the process are merged by saving the results as multiple documents with tracked changes visible. The operation generates a merge report with links to the documents. The first section contains the modified files that were merged. You can click on a document to open it in the editor. The next section contains the files that were added because they were only present in the directory to merge with. Note that if you're interested in automating these processes, these actions are also available from scripting. It is now possible to use XPath expressions inside SVG templates to insert dynamic text when creating PDF output. In this example, XPath expressions are used in the SVG file to define information that will be expanded by the processor and displayed in the cover page. The SVG file is then referenced in a custom CSS file, and in the resulting PDF output, information about the title, author, date, and copyright was retrieved from the XPath expressions that were added in the SVG file. We are excited to introduce the new Oxygen JSON Editor, a specialized product that was specifically designed for editing JSON and JSON schema documents and other related technologies. It includes text mode editing features such as the dedicated outline view that is synced with the editor and makes it easy to navigate to specific items within the document. The Intelligent Content Completion Assistant offers proposals for inserting JSON code. Along with text mode, JSON documents are also supported in the grid mode, as well as author mode. And JSON schema documents can be easily created and modified in the dedicated design mode. The JSON tools menu contains a comprehensive set of tools to assist you with converting, generating, and documenting JSON, JSON schema, YAML, and OpenAPI documents. The JSON editor also supports technologies such as YAML, HTML, CSS, LESS, Python, Text, Shell, and more. And you can even edit XML documents in text mode. And perhaps the most important part is that the JSON editor has an affordable subscription-based pricing option, providing access to the powerful JSON editing capabilities at a reasonable cost. The JSON diagram editor now also has its own dedicated outline view. It is synced with the diagram editor, and it presents all the properties, pattern properties, and definitions found within the document. You can also drag items from the outline view and drop them in an appropriate location in the diagram editor. When renaming a property in the JSON design mode, the required property field is now automatically updated by either modifying the property or deleting it from the array. Notice the email is listed as a required property. After deleting it, notice that it also removed email from the list of required values. We'll revert that. Then, after renaming the ID property to identifier, notice that the word was updated in the list of required properties. The YAML editing support continued to be enhanced, also boasting its own dedicated outline view. And the content completion and validation features are now on par with the JSON support. When using the new document wizard to create a new YAML document, a customize option is now available. This feature allows you to configure the generation of new YAML documents based on a specified JSON schema, ensuring consistency and adherence to predefined rules. A new Go to Definition action was added in the contextual menu to make it easy to quickly navigate to the component's definition. built-in Saxon processor used for XSLT and XQuery transformations and debugging was updated to version 12.3. You can see that the 12.3 options are available in the Transformer menu. The XSLT 4.0 support was updated. We'll change the XSL version to 4.0 in this document. Then we'll start adding content and invoke the content completion to show you that 4.0 extension functions are now available. These were just highlights of some of the new features added in Oxygen 26. For a complete list of all the additions, updates, and implementations, go to our What's New page on our website.